This is a song that, you know, is, I guess has some political things in it that I've written a long time ago. But it's really not a political song. It's more of a memorial to all the men who have served this country, including my grandfather, George Foster Griffin, who was a medic in World War II in the Battle of the Bulge, and he fought in the Hurricane Forest. And he used to not talk about the war very much, but he did used to tell me when I was a kid that he was the one that single-handedly ended World War II by shooting Adolf Hitler's mustache off and keeping it in his back pocket. So obviously he was a legend in my youthful mind, and I had to start writing songs about him. So I love having this one to remember him by, and some of the stuff he inspired in this song, I hope, you know, still remains relevant today. So it's called I Remember. My grandpa fought in World War II, my uncle fought in Nam. My father was too young, he went to school and met my mom. Her dad always told us stories around dinner time, and there's one he told when I was young that sticks out in my mind. He said 10 years after Daddy taught me about the birds and bees, I was stranded in Pearl Harbor fighting off the Japanese. When the kamikaze pilots came and dove in without warning, I was on the Arizona on a warm December morning. I remember I was a younger man. We were soldiers fighting in a foreign land. Now I'm older, and it's happening again. But it was hard to have forgiveness for the things they did that day. And our president decided we should make their people pay. Dropped on Nagasaki and we cut him down to size. And the one we dropped on Hiroshima left them vaporized. And I heard some Christians saying, what would Jesus do? What if you were on the wrong side? Would he point the gun at you? And they read through every word of Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and John, so they could see if killing was the side that Christ was on. I remember as a younger man, we were soldiers fighting in a foreign land. Now I'm older, and it's happening again. And they separate the church and state and keep God out of school, so governments can educate based upon their rules. But people start to wonder if our politics makes sense when religion is our best excuse for national defense. When our citizens start saying that our wars are not okay, Washington keeps telling them God loves the USA, and they teach us history so we can learn from our mistakes. And this generation wants to know how many years it takes to change the way our neighbors all across the land. Cause if we don't change our hearts, we repeat the past again. I remember when I was a younger man, we were soldiers fighting in a foreign land. Now I'm older, and it's happening again. We went walking, he and I. I was thinking of the future and how scared I was to die. Now my best friend's overseas, in the desert where it's dry, fighting for our country, and I need a reason why. I remember when he was a younger man. Now he's a soldier fighting in a foreign land. Now we're older. God bring him home again.